Was it Hammers and Loathing you came to?
I think it was anyway. And a short time after that, Rick had rejoined Yes, and I was working with different bands around London. And sorry, I'm not used to singing.
Oh, you're singing
now.
Well, it's just as good as. So I was working around town, and I was doing a gig at the Rock Garden in Covent Garden, and Chaz and Dave came down to see me at this particular concert. I was drunk that night. I don't normally drink when I'm playing, but I was absolutely hammered. I came to see him and someone said, "Hey, play well tonight because there's Straws in there, come to see you," you know. So hey, I did my best, which wasn't very good, but hey. They came up to me at the end of the night and said, "Can you come speak with us speakeasy?" So we went off to the speakeasy and got even more hammered at the club that night. And I thought, I like these guys, these are good people, you know. So the next day at about 11 in the morning, still too drunk to drive, I drove all the way over to Chaz's place, sat and had a chat with Chaz and Dave. Dave was heading off back down to Devon or something, and then we all organised an audition and a rehearsal, and then from that I got the gig basically. And the first thing I worked on that was the Deadlines album, and then we did a tour after that something.
Well, the thing is, when we finish this cruise at the end of the week, you're flying back, we're all flying back to England, and then you've got to go and do what?
Yeah, because, well, Rick, as you probably all know, Rick is still quite busy, does a lot of work, and he does a lot of orchestral concerts these days, and he's doing a 40th anniversary tour for the Journey to the Centre of the Earth album, which is first recorded in 1974. We re-recorded the album, did a studio version. It was a live album originally. We did a studio version August before last, slightly extended, a few new pieces in it, and slightly different arrangements. And that album is now going out on the road for the 40th anniversary of the Journey to Centre of the Earth. So as soon as I get back from this, I've got 2 days free to get myself together and start rehearsals with Rick, the orchestra and the choir, and off we go for a 14-day tour around the UK. Yeah.
Well, also,
plans for later in the year, if it all comes together, to do South America and some gigs in North America. So keep your eyes open. It might be there somewhere.
But anyway, you've got the idea of this disparate bunch of people, but there is a common thread somewhere that all begins to link together. But when we got together, first of all, with the revised band in 1973, John, we said, showed him to a Mellotron and a Moog synthesizer, and he thought, what the hell is this? But we thought, well, we've got to make a new album. And we're going to show you how a song evolves, and you may find it curious that there was a country lick I had, a sort of country guitar lick, based on a banjo tuning, and join in with it and play along with it. And then Dave began to put some chords on top of that as well, and so it began to sound like this. Began to come together, and we worked out the first verse, and it sounded okay. We got to the second verse and thought, well, we can't just carry on playing this sort of country jig sounding thing.
Can I just remind you that after we put that together, that first movement, you said, oh shit, I'm going to have to go and rewrite all these lyrics. probably left the rehearsal room.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes, you do remind me of it. Yeah, we were rehearsing in a village hall in the middle of the country, down in the wilds of East Devon, and there were literally farmers driving their cattle to the cows to be milked past the door of the place. There were women coming in with kiddies in their buggies to listen to what the heck was going on in this village hall. And where we were fiddling around, all around with this thing, we got to the second verse and I said, well, we can't just carry on playing this jiggy type thing. So being a folk singer, I said, well, what we'll do, I'll sing it a cappella. We will just sing it with me just singing it without any accompaniment whatsoever. Now, it sounded a bit of a strange idea, so we thought, well, the third verse, we'll all play it all together and we'll all sing together. But then we got to the middle section and thought, what the hell are we going to do with that? And Chas started to play some drooping bass lines, you know, that sort of... We thought, that sounds quite interesting. John began to put a bit of organ on top of that, and that sounded quite curious. Sort of, didn't it?
Still sounds curious.
Tell that John auditioned for the Phantom of the Opera. Anyway, by the time we put this whole thing together, I realised that this strange tuning I put the guitar into didn't really work. So I started put the guitar back into normal tuning. First time, and it sounds like this. Which she alone could offer. Dancing out before her feet, where the desert eyes should meet. He knew the life was incomplete, for he had yet to suffer. Yeah. how a bluegrass country guitar lick turned into something else. It turned the Straws from being what we were, which was almost a sort of folky come rocky group, and Rick had sort of contributed to that. It turned us much more towards the era of progressive rock. And that's how it all began, on that one little tiny little guitar lick. But I'll tell you what we'll do, we'll take you through another song and dissect that and show you how that all came to be, if that's okay with you.
Yeah.
I had a little tune I'd sort of been playing around with on the piano, and it was a very simple song written about walking out with my family and the wife and kids down by the River Thames at Richmond upon Thames near London, West London. And it was a very gentle song, and it was just a very repetitive chord, sort of repetitive melody. John will play the sort of melody for you. on organ. That was a very simple melody line like that. And we started to play through the first verse, and then we got to the second verse, and we thought, well, hang on, this is sounding a bit... Well, we've only got three verses. We've got to develop it a bit further. So we started to work on an instrumental section in the middle, because we thought it needed some variation. So John thought we should... Well, we thought we should change key with it. And normally when you... change key with a song, you change key at the end of the song to give the song a kick and take it up and make it more exciting. You take it up a tone, and it suddenly the whole record goes, you know, sounds much more exciting towards the end of the single, say. With us, we transcribed it not up but down. People don't do that normally, but just play through the sequence, John.
From where?
From where you fell asleep. To go down a tone and a half, but suddenly we found that to try and sing that was much more difficult, because you've gone from singing one key and then suddenly you've taken it down. So we thought, well, we'll cover that up by doing a three-part harmony. And okay, so we make the song sound a bit more interesting. Two, three, four. Rushing through the
we've been swiftly on.
You see, we can't pick it up from there, because what happened was that when we got to that section, it was too low to sing, so Dave took the melody line at the top and I sang a harmony, so the whole thing became totally chucked up in the air. But then we thought, well, we need an ending to the song, so John came up with a nice little theme. So nice that we decided to put it on the front of the song as well. It went sort of arse over tit, if you like. I think the whole song was. So what we've done, we've gone all the way through the song, got to the ending, and then decided to stick the ending on the beginning. And so therefore we then had the whole song together, and it goes like this.
Caterpillars in paperbacks.
how the Straubs turned from being a folky group, a bluegrass band, into a prog rock band, into Lord knows whatever we are now. But does anybody have any questions that you want to ask us, please?
I do.
Fire away.
I do. It's not a question, it's just that you guys sound so well, I think that we would all like to hear you just play some music, because we absolutely love what we play.
Yeah. Oh, thank you.
Yes? Huh? Thank you.
Yes. We're going to have some competition, so make it allowed.
All right. We don't
have
blame
them. It's not a typical storyteller.
Okay, well, we'll just do one more song. And if you want to see our shows, we're playing, I can't remember when, at the end of the week. We got 2 days off now to get over this. take it away, Steiger. Yeah. 1, 2, 3.
Lay down now, lay me down. Lay down now, lay me down. Lay down now, lay me down. Oh.